Hey guys, it's Briley and Jersey. Okay. And welcome back to another video. Báilame como si fuera la última vez y enséñame ese pasito que no sé, un besito bien suavecito, bebé. Taqui taqui, taqui taqui rum. Today, as you can probably see from the title, I'm doing a gear haul, and so I have a lot of gear, just a warning, so let's get started. So I'm just gonna start grabbing stuff. I have them all separated into piles around my room and on my bed, as you can see, around it, like right here. This is a pile of vests. In front of me, I have like my pouch section. So these are pouches. These are pouches that can go on a few of our vests. Inside, I have my gift card. I should use that. Some band-aids. Emergency information that needs to be updated, and then some rubber bands for my braces that I have in here. I'm gonna keep this out. Also, I don't know if you guys can tell better quality or not. I'm filming this on my Canon EOS 60D camera. So yeah, so that's what's in this one. And then I don't think there's anything in this one, but oh yeah, there is. Some masks, and then some pieces of gum. So, and then these also have little Velcro pouches, which this one doesn't have anything in the Velcro pouch. And oh, dog treats. Jersey, you want one? Some dog treats. So that's these pouches, and then I have this pouch that I was gifted that just has a carabiner closure. Sorry if I keep looking off to the side, that's where the viewfinder is. And then I don't think I have anything inside of it, I do not, but I put this on my crutches whenever I was on crutches. And yeah, so I was able to attach that to my crutches and hold my phone before I got a new phone. A phone that actually fit in here. This one won't. It won't fit. And then I have my treat pouch. This is the Rapid Rewards Doggone Good. A poop bag holder, so I have poop bags in there. Has D-rings, so I can put a water bowl. In the back, it has the zipper, which I just keep an extra mask in case I forget mine. Because Rona. And then it has another place that I could put something. I'm not exactly sure, maybe an extra roll of poop bags. And then in the front, it has this little Velcro thing that I usually keep my ID in, but right now it's my wallet, and then I have two ADA cards. I used to have like 4 or 5 in there, but as you can see, I've given them out during access issues. And then inside, I have treat pouch, and then it has another Velcro thing that I don't keep, that I don't have anything in, but it has treat crumbs in there that are just kind of falling. And my other one, I don't know if I ever did a gear. I don't remember if it was in my gear haul last time, but it had a drawstring closure, and this one you just go to close it and open it. It's really easy. And mine is just on the waist setting. And I have it in royal blue. You'll see that's kind of a theme in my stuff because I love royal blue and it looks beautiful on Jersey and Kylie both. Kylie is now almost fully retired. I don't remember the last time that I worked her, but if I desperately needed to work her, she is still good enough to work, but she's not my first choice, Jersey is. So that's my pouches. And next, I'm gonna do my leash wraps. So I have my Patience and Love leash wraps, and then I have one from Ryan Barrel on Instagram. I can try to link most of the stuff below. So, and I just store them using hair ties. So this one says, if you're gonna stare, at least follow us, and it has our Instagram. And it has that on both sides, and it just has two black snaps. And then our Patience and Love wraps. I'm just gonna undo all of them. So this one says, be patient, I'm learning, on both sides. And it just has the snap closure and then Patience and Love on the inside with the little pouch thing. This one says, handler needs space, keep back. Working service dog, do not approach. And then medical alert with an EKG. And I also, here, I store them stacked on top of each other, like this. I'm meaning to get another hair tie, or more of the hair ties, to store them with. But for now, this is just how I do it, and it works just fine. So next I'm going to go into like the shoe category. I hope I'm not blurry. I'm so sorry if I am. I'm trying to zoom out. Okay. I hope that's better. I still don't know if I'm blurry or not. I can't really see. So I have these. I have four of them, but the others are in the car. So I just got the one to show you. These are Kylie's boots. They have the rubber soles. They're the good-to-go all-weather boots from Petco. And they have the two reflector Velcro things. And these are the size large. Then I have some socks. I have four of them. I don't know what the other ones are. So we have these for right now. And they just have little rubber stuff at the bottom. And then I have these for Jersey. And this one is closed. They look kind of weird, but they're fine on her. And then they just have the drawstring closure. And then some rubber at the bottom. But it's not full rubber, it's just rubber. And then they're water rubber dots, and they're water resistant. And then next, I'm going to go on to collars. Okay, so here's Jersey's collar that she was wearing. It's just a rainbow pride collar. Again, I can link it at the bottom. And then she has her AKC tag that just says, I'm microchipped. And then her name on the back. So, put that back on her. And then I have this light-up collar, which it has strobe, and then it has a fast strobe and a slow strobe, and then it has a solid. I'm not going to show the strobes, but it worked awesome for 4th of July. And then here was Jersey's first ever collar. It's a royal blue Caesar Milan collar with her rabies tag on it. So I have this paracord pull strap with these types of clips. I can't use this anymore due to a sensory processing disorder. So I have this braided felt pull strap that was also way too long. This is a correct length for me. And then I have this nylon and Sherpa with these types of closure. And this is made for a harness that I have that I will be showing in the future. And then this was made by another handler. So the biggest thing that I have is this hotel sign room that says service dog in room, and a handicap medical, and then a handicap, and then a star of life. And then I have this little bow that attaches to one of their walking harnesses. And then they wear this over their neck. It's like a little necklace thing. We've used it for homecoming and church, but it can go with a lot. I have this We're a Team Forever this medical alert service dog, medical alert do not distract. I have two of these service dog patches, but I only have one right now. One is on another vest. I have this Not All Disabilities Are Visible with POTS and PTSD ribbon. Those are just the two that affect me. I'm not here for your entertainment. I'm here to do my job. I don't know if you can really see it, but I'm trying. I have these two Astapet patches. I've noticed if you have Ask to Pet rather than Do Not Pet, people tend to be more respectful. I also use this during socialization. I also have two more patches that I just can't find. So they're somewhere. But they go along with this, the Angel to My Stitch. Again, I can't really show you. It's hard. And then I have this service unicorn patch. I have this sew-on emergency information inside. And then I have these two that are with a set and some are also on the vest. Emergency information inside and PTSD service dog. They both have little Mickey. And then I have Together We Are Independent with a foot and a paw. So that's it for my patches. The patches that aren't on vests. I'm gonna move on to training tools. I have my opinions, you may have yours. I have my opinions. I am a balanced trainer. I do positive first, and if that isn't working for a dog, then I move to the aversive tools. A head halter was working for Kylie, but then she realized that she can still pull through it, and I didn't want to hurt her neck. So a chain and a prong helped a lot. And then Jersey didn't work with a head halter. She didn't do good with one. So we had to move to a prong. Oh. First, here is our halty. This is our halty. So we do use halties and gentle leaders. That is my first step. And then we go to prongs. This is Kylie's prong, and this is Jersey's prong. Kylie doesn't have a quick release, but she barely uses hers anymore because she doesn't need it as much. She doesn't need it as much. And then Jersey uses a quick release Hermspringer. You can see the trachea guard. And then the Hermspringer. It won't show up, but you get the point, and then it has the quick release. And then I also have a carabiner attached to her collar in case for whatever reason the quick release decides to undo. For training, I muzzle train. So I just have Jersey's muzzle here. This also fits Kylie. And then we have our 50-foot leash for recall training. So that's what this is. And I didn't know what category to put this in, because I didn't really have a costume category. But this was for Kylie's Halloween costume. She has a devil. So, yeah. So first I have this over-the-collar service dog do not pet from Kenai's Creations. Then I have this plain red bandana, also for Kylie's Halloween costume. Then I have a bunch of American flag bandanas for my dogs. Then I have two white bandanas. I have two black bandanas. I have a pink bandana, a yellow bandana, a teal, an ombre teal bandana, and then this light blue bandana. Now I'm going to move on to like walking harnesses. So I only have two. This is a royal blue walking harness. It's a Y front and it's difficult, but there we go. So it's a Y front, more like a T front, but this is how it does. And then I have this neon pink kind of weird front thing. And this goes through this, and then it clips. And then the D-ring is right here. And it is very reflective. So here is Kylie's coat. We just got this from Walmart, and it works very well. It's pink. And then these are pajamas for Kylie. If I can show you. They're more Christmas because they have reindeer horns on the hood, but pajamas. And we got those from TJ Maxx. Okay, so here's another adversive is a flexi. I use flexies in a controlled environment. I will never use them if the environment is not a controlled environment. And I will never not just let a dog free reign. If I want them to be this far, I'll take it and lock it, and it works. If I want to be further, or if I am in, if I'm on like my property and they can free reign, I will let them. But my rule is they have to have a recall for a strong recall before they can go on a flexi. So, got that out of the way. Here is some of my leashes, and here are the rest. So here's just this plain red. I don't know really what it's doing, but I don't really use it anymore. But it's just a basic red leash. And then I have this long leather leash that I don't use. I'm actually selling it, but and the end of it doesn't have anything. That is why I don't use it. I'm just kind of grabbing out of my pile. And then I have a decent amount of slip leads in here. I have this blue slip lead. I have this purple bark to end Alzheimer's slip lead. And then I have this Hunter's Green Remington slip lead. And then I have this long leather leash. This is the closure and it is a braided style. And this is the end of it, which is a normal handle. This I got from Service Dog World on Instagram. All of these leather leashes that I've shown so far. Then here's the last one that I have from Service Dog World. That's just this cream leather. All of those are really, really nice leather. And then this, I'm not exactly sure where it's from. It also doesn't have anything on it, but it's just this like little, just like cream leather leash. Then I have this Bone Diggers black show leash that has this. I don't use this, I've never used this. And then here are the leashes that we use more than most. So here is one of our walking leashes, or one of our mess leashes. Then here is one of our just plain black leashes. Then I have this rainbow heart leash. Then here are our two most used leashes. I have this 6-foot leash from Tractor Supply that Jersey decided to chew on, but I just put a leash wrap over it. And I use it as a hands-free. And then I have this hands-free Biosane leash. It can be moved to a normal, or I can use the floating O-ring. But this is mainly a guide dog leash. So I'm gonna do capes first. So first I have this cape from Ryan Barrel on Instagram, Medical Alert Canine, Do Not Distract, with no eye contact, no touch, no talk, and no pictures on both the sides. And then on the top it says, it is illegal to interfere with a service dog. Stop. Her safety depends on your respect. And then it has snaps as the cape closure. And the belly strap. And then I have this that my friend made for me. It is a stitch. And then it has this little Puma, little keychain. And then it has these clips. Okay. Now here is, we use this for guide for Jersey. It isn't pressure yet, but it is just learning how to guide. It has embroidered service canine, and then I put a cape on it that says in training, because you should always mark your dog in training. And this is from Ryan Barrel, and everything, all this is from Ryan Barrel on Instagram. And then I have this vest. It says Service Shark Medical Equipment, Do Not Distract, on both sides with a little shark. And then on the top, it says, I keep her afloat. I'm her lifeguard with a shark on it. And this was from Rough Service Gear on Instagram, I believe. And then here was the first vest that I ever made. I understand it's terrible, but first vest that I ever made. And then this is the second vest that I ever made, which was a lot better. And then here is our tactical. It is an Ice Fang tactical from Amazon. I'm just buckling it. So, it has a more of a triangle ring up here if you're using it as a protection dog or a no-pull front. So on the front, it just says service dog. On the sides, it says service dog in training, cardiac, and syncope alert on both sides. And then on the top, it says do not distract. My mom's safety depends on your respect. Give us space with the other little Mickey Mouse patch. Service dog, do not separate from handler. Do not separate from handler. And then service dog, if my handler is down, do not separate. Do not call 911 unless injured, and give us space. So this is our Ice Fang Tactical. And then here is our Wire Dog Gear Vest. Hold on, one of the patches on it is weird. Fix that. Okay. So it just says service dog. The service dog ones are sewn on, and then this is a Velcro, do not pet. And then on this, I have a poop bag. And then I have this tag that was Jersey's old collar tag that says I'm a service dog. You can't really see it, but it's another AKC tag. And then if Jersey's working, I have a Velcro leash wrap that I don't have on me currently. And that goes right here, and it says service dog in training. And then I have one of our probably favorite vests from Patience and Love. Cardiac response and alert service canine. No talk, no touch, no eye contact, no pictures, do not distract on both sides. And then they have zippers. And inside this zipper, I have poop bags, an ADA card, and then her business cards. So, and because I've gotten a lot of questions of, oh, well, where'd you get that leash wrap, where'd you get this vest? And so I'm able to hand out her card. And then on this side, I don't have anything, but I thought I did. Look, this is a 17-inch panel, but if you were curious, I forgot that it said. And then on the back it says, stay back, I count her heartbeats. I love Patience and Love. I could not say enough good things about it. It's very good quality, very good customer service. It doesn't matter if you have a service dog, a pet dog, a reactive dog, any type of dog that would need markings on it, a protection dog, just a puppy that you're socializing. So that is all of our gear, I believe. So, Jersey, come here. Jersey, come here. Hey, come here. Come here. She's asleep back here. You can see her nose. Hey, come here. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye. This is the moment, tonight is the night. We'll fight.